Today I'm going to be talking about magazines for the 45 1911, and this is the new Wilson 10 rounder. I'm going to be using it in my SIG 1911. It's mainly my home defense because of the length of the grip. In the winter with the coat on, it's fine. With this type of shirt where I usually carry concealed, it prints a little bit. So we're going to go out and do this one, and mainly just firing for function, not accuracy, but we'll just shoot her and see. Put about 50, 60 rounds through it. Not on camera. Once you see it shoot, it isn't going to change no matter how many rounds I shoot. Let me widen it up a little bit. Here. Cover all bases. All right. So mainly, like I said, it's for function, not for accuracy. Just to see if this first round's fired out of my new 10-round magazine. Alrighty. Feels good. Shoots good. I pulled one out of a 9-ring. The rest are pretty in there, pretty much. But like I say, not for accuracy. Wilson 10-rounder. It sticks out a little bit, like you say, to make up for it. But for home defense, gives me 2 extra rounds. Will that make a difference? Probably not. Is it nice to have just in case? Probably so. Because Wilson magazine, the 10-rounder, isn't the cheapest magazine you can buy, but I like it. It's all a matter of personal taste, so that's it. It works. Now, well, I don't know if it works completely yet, but I'll put at least 50 rounds through it. But I've never had too much trouble with Wilson magazines.
Yeah, I'm doing a mag test with the Wilson. And mainly I'm just testing function and accuracy, but I always like to shoot good at least. I mean, it shot pretty good, real rapid fire here. My first magazine full. I'll shoot the head this time from about 7 yards or so. The 10 rounder, Wilson, SIG, 1911. Yes, he works. Works pretty good. Shooting wise in, feels good. Wilson 10 rounder. I'm gonna test some more, but that's enough on camera for what we're doing.
This is the new 10 shot Wilson. Wilson magazine. This is their standard new 8-round magazine, which I've been carrying. The 10 shot is extended. It looks a little bit different, but the same quality Wilson magazine. Got the same blade, doesn't tip down. It's got material that feels like it just slides right out. Now this is an old Wilson from my old close quarter combat from about 15, 17 years ago. Maybe a little longer than that. And that's the newest one. This has more of a polymer. I don't know what kind of material this is. This old one was all steel. A little smaller goes in the frame, but this won't fit in my SIG full size because the CQB was a commander style grip. And this in here is an old Colt. It was way back in the 70s, I believe, this one. That's probably a 6 or 7 rounder. Yeah, probably a 6 or 7 rounder. I think this is a Kimber, real compact model. Can't remember, it's one of the 45 ones I have hanging around. But this is the new 10. This is the current standard 8. This is the old commander size Wilson magazine. All high quality, lips don't split. It's been around, had a lot of rounds through it. Doesn't tip forward. The old Colts, they have a piece here, keeps you from tipping forward too much, but you still can a little bit, but it's a pretty good old magazine, the Colt. Government Colt 45 Ops, that's the bottom. This is a real old one. So this is old school, these are new school, and I've never had a problem with any of my Wilson magazines. So just wanted to put that in there since I got this new 10 window on my first test report on it. And I shot a box of 50 through it today. at the high speed just to test them, and they're shooting quite well. And no problems at all with cheap Walmart ammo, by the way. So that's pretty good. Wilson magazines, Colt magazines, I think it's a Kimber, I can't remember. Pretty sure it's a Kimber. That's it for the magazine test today.